Welcome, students. Hello. All right. So, welcome, everyone, to the 22nd Annual Fine Arts Assembly. I'm Jared Bardar.
And I'm Jane Blinkhorn.
And we'd like to thank the jazz band before we start. They just played When a Man Loves a Woman.
Speaking of our instrumental music program, this fall our marching band performed at all varsity football games and the Maslin Band Show. In the winter, instrumental music students participated in the OMEA Solo and Ensemble Contest. All three of our concert bands, Concert Band, Symphonic Band, and Wind Ensemble, received superior ratings of a 1 at the OMEA Large Group Contest. In April, our students organized a chamber concert that was completely student-run with student compositions. The band will also perform in the community for the Blue Tip Parade, the Candlelight Walk, and will be marching in the Memorial Day Parade. The band also provides community service by adopting a family through the Salvation Army at Christmas time. Let's give it up for our instrumental music students.
We would now like to welcome Harvard University alumni Sharon Alberson of the Harvard Club of Northeast Ohio to the podium to present the Harvard Book Award to one of our deserving junior English students.
Good morning. The Harvard Prize Book Program was established by Harvard alumni in 1910 as part of an effort to attract the attention of talented young students to the opportunities at the college. In the program's first years, a prize book was awarded at only a handful of schools in the New England area. Today, nearly 2,000 prize books sponsored by the local Harvard alumni are awarded in schools all over the world. The prize book of the Harvard Alumni Association is awarded to an outstanding student in the next two graduating class who displays excellence in scholarship and high character, combined with achievement in other fields. This year's prize book is offered to Emily Heckler.
Wadsworth High School Winter Guard just finished their third successful season. This group competes against other high schools throughout the state of Ohio. With 12 members, they managed to rank top three in their class at every competition this season. Their 2017 show is performed to the song Piece by Piece by Kelly Clarkson and tells the story of a daughter whose father abandoned her family and how the love of her husband helped put the pieces back together. Their dedication and drive continue to make this group a success year after year. Without further ado, performing their 2017 program titled The Missing Piece is the Wadsworth High School Winter Guard.
Please don't leave, Daddy.
Thank you, Wintergard, for that stellar performance. At this time, I'd now like to welcome Mr. Finley of the United States Air Force Academy and Mr. France of the United States Naval Academy to announce the appointments of two of our seniors into this prestigious academic institutions.
This time I'd like Matthew McMillan to come down, please. Nice shirt, by the way. Good morning. My name is Robert France, and I'm a blue and gold officer with the United States Naval Academy. It's my distinct pleasure to have the opportunity today to recognize the significant honor that Matt has earned by receiving an appointment to the United States Naval Academy in Annapolis, Maryland. This year, Matt was one of approximately 16,500 students from throughout the country who applied for one of about 1,200 appointments. The admissions process is unique and requires each student to apply for and receive a nomination, most commonly from their congressional representative or senator, complete a thorough medical exam, and successfully pass a physical fitness evaluation, in addition to the usual submission of transcripts, recommendations, and essays. Screening is thorough with a focus on well-rounded individuals who have demonstrated leadership potential and a willingness to accept responsibility, as well as outstanding academic credentials. An appointment to the United States Naval Academy is equivalent to a full four-year scholarship, including tuition, room and board, medical and dental benefits, and a monthly midshipman stipend. So you actually earn money. After completing the four-year curriculum at the Naval Academy, students receive a Bachelor of Science degree in one of 25 majors and earn a commission as an officer in the United States Navy or Marine Corps. We should all be very proud of Matt's accomplishment, and on behalf of the Superintendent of the United States Naval Academy, it is my pleasure to present this certificate of appointment to the class of 2021.
Good morning. If Cody Surratt would come down, please. Morning, Cody. Good to see you. My name is Mike Finley, and I'm an admissions liaison officer for the United States Air Force Academy in Colorado Springs, Colorado. It's my pleasure and privilege to represent the United States Air Force and the Director of Admissions of the Air Force Academy this morning to present Mr. Cody Lauren Surratt with an appointment to the Air Force Academy. From an academic standpoint, and this is going to sound a lot like my friend Bob's information, this appointment is equivalent to being offered a full four-year scholarship to a top-tier university with a value of over $45,000 per year. Appointments to the military academies are highly competitive. Cody competed with more than 10,000 other high school seniors for admission to the Air Force Academy and is one of approximately 1,400 to receive an offer of appointment, and ultimately his class will be limited to about 1,250. He will be joining a select group of students training to become leaders of character in your Air Force. During his 4 years at the Air Force Academy, Cody will have the opportunity to participate in many leadership development programs to include flying aircraft, free fall parachuting, jumping out of airplanes, Division I athletics. I believe Cody is planning to wrestle for the Academy. We're excited about that. Or intramural sports if he chooses, as well as participating in military training and foreign exchange programs around the world. He will pursue an academic major of his choosing in one of 26 academic disciplines, ranging from aeronautical and electrical engineering to history and political science. In addition, Cody will study Air Force history, military affairs, leadership, philosophy, and management. While Cody is a cadet, the Air Force will pay his entire tuition and room and board, and I hear the food is pretty good, Cody, and provide a basic monthly pay. Including the many extracurricular experiences available, the entire value of this appointment is estimated at $415,000. When Cody graduates from the Air Force Academy, he will earn a Bachelor of Science degree and be commissioned as an officer, a second lieutenant, in the United States Air Force. Now, approximately half of each graduating class will go on to Air Force pilot training, and many others will have the opportunity to earn advanced degrees as well. All graduates will eventually begin working in one of 38 officer career fields in the world's premier air, space, and cyberspace force. Cody, I'm extremely proud of you. It's a great honor for me to make this presentation and to recognize the years of hard work that you've put in and brought to this, that have brought you to this point in your life. Congratulations, and I wish you the very best in your Air Force career.
All right, I would now like to ask Maria Ruggiero, Editor-in-Chief of Wadsworth High School Bruin, to announce the editors for next year and the staffer of the year.
Hi, everyone. My name's Maria Ruggiero, and like Jared said, I'm the current editor-in-chief of our school paper, The Bruin. This year has been a very daunting year, with our class being passed from Coach G last year to Mr. Heffinger, and many changes ensuing. However, despite these difficulties, The Bruin has enjoyed great successes with our writers and editors, winning 14 awards at the Ohio Scholastic Media Association Awards, OSMA for short, four of which were Excellence Awards. In addition to this, The Bruin won the first place award at the OSMAs, the first year we have done so since 1999. This year, we have also launched our website, wadsworthbruin.com, which has reached over 4,000 views since December. We have also had a multitude of submissions to the paper from student and teacher writers, and we encourage many more for the year to come. Speaking of the year to come, I would like to introduce our editors for the 2017-2018 school year. Please stand up when I say your name. Business and editor of the sports department is Josh Higgins. Our media and art editor is Alyssa Lykos. The online editor is Nate Barnett. The entertainment editor is Tori Baker. Our two news editors are Jackie Toth and Ahmed Darwich. And our editor-in-chief for the 2017-2018 school year is Quentin Griffin. Lastly, I would like to congratulate our staffer of the year. When I say your name, please come and accept your award. So, this person not only has worked hard on everything they were assigned since the day they entered the Bruin classroom, but they have also made my job as editor-in-chief so much easier. So I'd like to thank and congratulate our staffer of the year, Emily Andrews. Thank you, and bye, Bruin.
The Wadsworth High School Choir Department has had a busy year with lots of excitement. In October, we sponsored our second annual Show Choir Kids Camp, consisting of more than 70 elementary school students in the district. In December, we performed our holiday show 16 times around town, including all elementary schools and various business luncheons. All four choirs performed in four concerts per school year, as well as at the Fine Arts Festival held this last weekend. Choir students also had the opportunity to attend two Broadway shows this year at Playhouse Square, including The King and I and Something Rotten. This past January, 15 choir and drama students traveled to Disney World to participate in a Disney Sings and Broadway Sings workshop. While there, we were surprised by CMA Vocal Group of the Year, Little Big Town. The students not only performed for them, but we also helped them kick off the national Keep Music in Our Schools tour. Check out our video on the Disney Parks blog. The first group to perform today is our women's chorus, consisting of non-auditioned women from grades 9 through 12. They will be singing One Fine Day from the film Rags to Riches. The soloist is Margaret Stasko with choreography by Katie Callow.
Thank you.
next group is Elite Choir, consisting of 10th through 12th grade auditioned girls and the 9th through 12th grade non-auditioned men's chorus. They will perform Can't Stop the Feelin' from the DreamWorks film Trolls. Soloists are Brendan Phillips and Joel Wichterman, with choreography by Philip Crawshaw.
Change back in the pose of the Bernie speaks.
Reading the I do. Oh wait.
I've got this feeling inside my home. It goes electric wavy when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home.
I'm
last group is our top performing show choir. It consists of 16 males and 16 females in 10th through 12th grade. They will be performing I'm a Believer from Shrek and choreographed by Philip Crawshaw. We hope you enjoy. Now, I would like to present the Outstanding Vocal Music Student of the Year. When you hear your name called, please come to the podium to be recognized and receive your award. The Outstanding Vocal Music Student of the Year is Natalie Manassa. Our spring concert, A Night at the Movies, is this coming Friday, May 5th at 7:30 p.m. We invite you all to come enjoy a night of excellent singing and dancing in the pack. And now, I would like to present the Outstanding Students of the Year for Latin, French, and Spanish. Again, when you hear your name called, please come to accept your award and be recognized. The Outstanding Student of the Year for Spanish is Michaela Macco. The Outstanding Student of the Year for French is Emma Marshall. And the Outstanding Latin Student of the Year is Andrew Edwards. Next is the OFLA Awards. The Student Achievement Award for the Ohio Foreign Language Association is intended for Ohio students who have achieved success in language study. Teachers select students based on their overall performance using the language. The OFLA Award for Latin is Daniel Johnson. Emily Brown, French. AJ Arch, Spanish. And Brent Runkle, Spanish.
Next, we will move on to speech and debate. So, competing in speech and debate provides students with incredible opportunities to challenge themselves academically, achieve personal growth, and improve their critical thinking, argumentative, and communication skills. Throughout the season, students spend hours practicing, refining, revising, and perfecting performance pieces in an attempt to earn top placements at tournaments. This season, the speech and debate team earned many top placements, both individually and as a team. Wadsworth High School will be sending four students to that national tournament this year. Those students include Natalie Manassa, Jake Wilkinson, Emily Brazier, and Garrett Freund. Let's give them a round of applause. In addition to a successful regular season, Wadsworth earned a state championship in dramatic interpretation. Here today to perform part of her winning state championship in dramatic interp is Emily Brazier. Now, in dramatic interpretation, a student will select a piece of literature, be it a prose, a play, or a short story, that both communicates an idea and moves people emotionally. The performance will be given as an individual without any props or costume. And now, Emily Brazier will perform "I Got Sick, Then I Got Better."
I Got Sick, and Then I Got Better, by Jenny Allen. Well, I found out I was sick. Cancer, obviously. But you see, all of those depressed bald women out there, I was determined not to be one of them. Or don't get me wrong, I was bald too, but personally, I thought we were all in a great place. You know, we were getting the treatment that we needed. We were like a sorority, and I was the eager new pledge. I would smile at my fellow patients, and I'd give them a little wave, and they'd smile back, probably hating me. But I felt good, and I wasn't acting. And then one day, I got my pathology report. So I laid it on the kitchen table, and I called my friend Donna so she could come over and read it to me, because, well, she was a nurse, and I didn't know anything about all of this stuff. So she reads it, and she looks at me, and she says, "You're a 2C, Jenny." Okay. Cool. I knew I was a stage 2, I didn't know this crap had letters. What comes after 2C? 3. And after 3 is 4. And after 4 is I stood up, and I went upstairs, and I laid there with the covers pulled over my head for 13 hours. Until my husband got home. Don't get me wrong, I love my husband. Well, I loved my husband. You know, he's a good person. He's just not entirely present. So he gets home from work that day, and I go up to him and I say, "I'm a 2C, Jules." And he says, "Okay, cool. What's for dinner? What's for dinner? What's for dinner? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? I needed a husband who would be my advocate. You know, someone who would fuss over me. Someone who would look up all the details about my disease and then tell them to me, leaving out all of the depressing parts. And not someone who would ask me, what's for dinner? But I hated that, you know? That. And people would always try to do things to comfort me, but everything they did to try and comfort me just pissed me off. People would say, "Oh, there's always someone worse off than you, Jenny." But how are you supposed to feel good about your own calamity by measuring it against another person's worst calamity. And what if that worse off person is you? Oh, at least I'm not Jenny, that would suck. People always tell me that you never get more than you can handle. No. No, people get more than they can handle all the time. That's why they jump off of buildings and kill themselves. And the one that I hate the most is when people tell me that everything happens for a reason. No, lots of things happen for no reason at all, or more reasons than you can ever possibly tease apart. And besides, what they mean when they say everything happens for a reason is that everything happens for a purpose. And I'm sorry. Sorry, I think that life is beautiful and amazing. Gift. But I just don't believe in that kind of divine direction. I believe that accidents happen. And you know, I still have no answers. So I have this checkup. My oncologist. And I go, and she looks at me and she says, "How are you feeling, Jenny?" So I give it to her straight. I feel like what has happened to me is like being in a really, really violent car accident, but that accident is still happening. I feel like this world, like this place, we're supposed to have people that were supposed to protect me, but they hadn't.
Each year, the speech and debate team selects a student of the year. Students are selected for this award not only to uphold the values of Wadsworth High School, but also the Ohio High School Speech League and the National Speech and Debate Association. In selecting the student of the year, the team considers academics, competition awards, and service to the community and the team. This year's student of the year is Jake Wilkinson. Over the last 4 years, Mr. Derrick and Mr. Sharla have been lucky to have had many, if not most, of the students in the class of 2017 take their art classes. During this time, there are a number of students who have put in the dedication that it takes to complete 4 years of art accumulating and completing AP art this year. In doing so, they all had to work very hard and complete a number of outstanding pieces of art. Please stand and be recognized. These students are McKenna Banks, Zach Beatty, Emily Brazier, Maddie Bushai, Greta Conley, Connor Kaur, Kim Crookston, Emily Eggleton, Christian Hall, Alex Hitch, Julia Hauser, Lauren Nipple, Caitlin Lewis, Glenn Might, Alex Moran, Aaron Murphy, Riley O'Brien, Montana Pollock, Savannah Roddy, Charlie Samaro, Emma Stedman, Hannah Thompson, Natalie Walton, Macy Whitaker, and Kyle Zufra. Their 4 years of art was finished with a great senior display at the Distinct Fine Arts Festival this past weekend. Mr. Derrick said that this was the best display in his 6 years at the high school. At this year's festival, Savannah Roddy won Best of Show Portfolio, Hannah Thompson won First Place Portfolio, Zach Beatty and Kim Crookston were awarded second and third for their portfolios. Hannah Thompson's very imaginative marker rendering of a fantasy landscape won Best of Show Individual Piece of Artwork. These senior students have also won numerous gold and silver keys in the Scholastic Art Competition, along with many honorable mentions. This year, Zach Beatty took first, Aaron Murphy took second place in the Medina County Art League Senior Portfolio Show. Each took home some scholarship money as well. Many of the students have also been awarded a significant amount of scholarship money towards the universities of their choice. I would now like to present the Outstanding Art Student of the Year. And the award goes to Savannah Roddy.
Wadsworth High School Drama Department has had another successful year. This fall, we presented our family production, A Little Magic, and the American literary classic, The Crucible. This spring, we presented the Elton John and Tim Rice musical, Aida, and the audience participation comedy, The Clumsy Custard Horror Show and Ice Cream Clone Review. The production of Aida was also part of the Playhouse Square Dazzle Award education process. Competing against 22 other high schools and has earned 3 nominations in the categories of Best Technical Execution, Best Student Orchestra, and Katie Callow was nominated for Best Feature Performer for her role as Nehebka. Katie, Evan Goble, Rachel Herman, and Macy Schaefer will represent the cast and will perform on the Playhouse Square Palace stage on May 20th during the Dazzle Awards presentation. Aida is the triumphant love story between an Egyptian prince and a Nubian slave, which transcends warring nations and brings a country together. The cast of Aida will now present The Gods Love Nubia, a number from Act One, where Aida, the Nubian princess, rallies her people and assures them that Nubia will never die.
Across the
now, I would like to present the Outstanding Drama Student of the Year. When your name is called, please come to the podium and accept your award. The Outstanding Drama Student of the Year is Rachel Herman. Next, I would like to introduce Brody Brandeberry, the business manager of our yearbook, The Whisperer, to do his awards.
Good morning, Wadsworth High School. My name is Brody Brandeberry, and I'm here to announce the yearbook Staffers of the Year and next year's editors. This year, the yearbook staff has completed a 256-page, full-color book documenting the entire 2016-17 school year. Through dedication, fantastic leadership, and a commitment from the entire staff, we are sure you'll be proud of this year's book, which you can still order at jostens.com. This year's staffers of the year were chosen by their classmates. Please come to the podium when I call your name. The junior staffer of the year is Camden Brady. The senior staffer of the year is editor-in-chief Christy. To conclude by announcing the 2017-18 yearbook editors. Please stand when your name is called. Business manager, Brooke Lehmeyer. Marketing manager, Hannah Toulis. Sports editor, Stacy Witchy. Photo editor, Devin O'Connor. Assistant editor-in-chief, Gracie Thompson. Assistant Editor-in-Chief, Jordan Mitch. And the 2017-2018 Editor-in-Chief is Camden Brady. Thank you.
All right. I would now like to announce the winners of the Medina County Auditor Seal Contest. All right, so when you drive to the gas station, have you ever noticed the inspected and sealed stickers that are on the gas pumps? And when you stop at the grocery store, have you ever noticed the stickers on the scales that weigh your produce? Hand scanners that read the barcodes on products that you have purchased have price verification stickers. These stickers inform you, the consumers, that the weights and measures are correct on these devices. In Medina County, look for these stickers because they are designed by high school students, unlike stickers that are designed in neighboring counties. What is even more exciting is that this year, three students from Wadsworth High School were chosen amongst 200 entries across participating Medina County high schools. We'd like to recognize students from Mrs. Van Dyke's Business Computer Applications class, Timothy Bergen, Bethany Baker, and Mason Fortner for their creative designs. The Wadsworth Jazz Ensemble is composed of elite members of the trumpet, trombone, saxophone, and percussion sections of the Wadsworth Band Program, as well as several students that double on piano and bass in order to fill out our rhythm section. These students auditioned and joined the ensemble because they wanted to extend their performance opportunities beyond concert, pep, and marching band, and into a diverse styles associated with jazz idiom. We play a wide array of music across many genres and styles, and have performed over 25 pieces this year for numerous audiences in a variety of venues, accumulating in an hour-long set on the 94th floor of the John Hancock Center in Chicago, Illinois, some 1,030 feet above street level. The jazz band will now perform Sing, Sing, Sing by Louis Prima, arranged by David Wolpe. I would now like to present the Outstanding Instrumental Student of the Year. And the award goes to Emma Marshall.
Least, I would like to introduce Michaela Macko, the president of the National Honor Society, to present the Teacher of the Year Award. Every year, the Teacher of the Year Award is presented by the National Honor Society to recognize one teacher in our high school who not only demonstrates an outstanding motivation for teaching, but also for his or her exemplary contributions to our schools and our students' success. Teachers are nominated for the award by both students and other teachers. The National Honor Society then discusses each of the nominees and collectively decides who receives this tremendous honor. This year's chosen recipient has been teaching for 37 years. Throughout this time, he has always had a smile on his face and is constantly cracking jokes. I had the honor of having him as a teacher in my junior year. There was never a dull moment in class, as he often made jokes about NAM in the old days. Even though the course was difficult, his passion for making us understand the content was always evident. Willing to help students outside of class time, giving clear instructions on worksheets and materials, but most of all, his pure excitement with teaching copious amounts of difficult course material and still values of hardworking students that carries into fostering their success. One of the greatest lessons one can learn from experiencing his teaching is how important a passion for what you do and a passion for others is. To this day, every time I see him in the hall, he always takes the time to start up a conversation or ask how I'm doing. He appreciates the willingness of students to learn and in turn is eager to hear what plans students have after high school. He is quick to offer encouragement to others and is always supportive. Outside of school, his passion for teaching continues as a coach, taking his time to develop young athletes with characteristics of sportsmanship and commitment. Players describe him as compassionate, dedicated, and motivational, words that truly describe a man worthy of such a high honor. As president of the National Honor Society, and on behalf of all young chemists present today, I am honored to present this award to Mike Schmelzer, Sr.
It'll be short and sweet, gang. 9:30 is the deadline. All I can say is this, I've been here for about 25 years, and I love y'all as students, I love y'all as just great kids. This really, really did extend my teaching career coming here to Wadsworth High School. Thank you so much.
Our 22nd annual Fine Arts Assembly. Please return to second period. Woo!